I'm about to enter the great state of Nevada here on a warm summer night. Okay, we're making our way up to this mine right here across the gully. I believe this was a talc or soapstone mine. And you see there a collapsed ore bin. Looks like it kind of fell over, kind of forwards right there. And some other interesting structures up on top right there. And then some kind of metal frame right there. Don't know if that's a head frame or what, but we're gonna go check it out. And we are making our way around this gully you see here below me, up this old mining road right here in front of me. So let's keep on going. Okay, while Paul adjusts his equipment, helmet, batteries, stuff like that, here's looking at the entrance to the mine. We're at a talc mine, as you can tell here. Really no other talc present on the hillside, except right here's a talc body that they punched the tunnel through. That's what they did. They looked for an outcropping of whatever ore they were trying to mine, in this case talc, and that's where they would start digging a tunnel. And we're about to enter that tunnel. And here's the shot looking in. It kind of goes down in an incline here and then levels out. And I think there's a drop-off back there. I can see it. Looks like it drops off. Let's carefully check this out. Yep, there's some kind of wood structure down here. Don't know if it's a head frame or what. Yeah, we certainly do our fair share of talc mines. They're not our favorites because, as you know, talc is really unstable, and these mines are always full of fractures and collapses. So they're not our most favorite mines, but they are kind of cool, a change from the hard rock mines. Okay, so what do we got here? Looks like an ore chute. This is really interesting because the tunnel kind of stops here, but continues on with this ore chute. Look at that. Let me get a better shot there. Let me zoom down there. That's where we're going to head. And Paul's making entry into the mine, the talc mine. And that's what it looks like looking back out towards the portal. And like I said, we're going to climb up on this wood chute and head down that way. You can see the tunnel kind of curving off to the left there. That might be the end of it. I'm not sure. Okay, there's the chute we just climbed up. You can see daylight there to the left. That's where we came into the mine, and we're gonna head down this tunnel. Paul's already gone ahead and checked it out. It goes a little ways, and there's some cool stuff up here. He said there's some interesting rock features, and there's an incline shaft to the outside. Right up here on the right. There's the timbers from the bottom of the incline shaft that goes to daylight. You can sort of see daylight way up there at the top. And then we'll keep going this way, straight ahead. Okay, so here's this branching, steeply sloping tunnel off the main tunnel. You can see where the talc kind of ran out there. See where the rock turns gray? That's where they stopped digging for the talc, and then it kind of went down there. And that just bottoms out at a pit down there. They probably would have gone further. It looks like there's more talc right there at the back of that pit, but they chose to stop there for some reason. And so looking around here, heading back up to the main tunnel, which is that way. And off to the right, you see Paul. And there's that timbered arch for the incline shaft. And then the tunnel will go this way. We'll turn this way and check this out. Again, you can see where the talc deposit ran out, and they ran into rock that wasn't talc, that gray rock. And then panning around here, that's just where we came from, that incline passageway. And there's some gobbing. when they stack the rocks up like that, they call that gobbing. And it was easier to do that than to haul them out of the mine. And the main entrance is down that way where we came from. So once again, right here, you can see where the talc body ran out. And right there's the line of demarcation. And you can see it almost like a fault line because it's really smooth right there. And there's one of the blasting holes for the dynamite. But you can see that fault line right there. Talc on the left and then the gray rock on the right, which is right here behind us, this big outcropping. And then the tunnel continues this way, but it ends at a dead end. And there's no talc here. This is strictly this gray rock. And that's called the face of the mine where they stopped, and there's some blasting holes there. And that's pretty much it. And here's a shot looking back at that timbered arch. And let's go check out the other branching tunnel. Okay, here's the other branching tunnel. Again, you can see the talc body right here on the right. And here is the line of demarcation. That's pretty clear cut. Isn't that amazing? So the talc is on the right, and this other rock, which isn't talc, is on the left. And it looks like they kept digging. Up here in the ceiling, you can also see the same line of demarcation right there. And they kept digging. They probably followed this talc deposit. You can see it in the ceiling. And it looks like it kind of peters out. There's a little bit right there on the left. And then you have a timbered arch here. And it looks like that's pretty much where they encountered some really dark colored rock, and that's where the talc ran out. So that's it. And here's looking back at what we just came through. Okay, we're about to make our way back up this short inclined entry tunnel to the exit. And this was a small mine, but had some cool features like the fault lines and things like that. So this was a pretty good example of a small talc mine out here in the desert. So I hope you enjoyed the tour. Let's go check out some other tunnels that are in the area. So you're looking down on this collapsed ore chute, and you can see right here where the ore cart track is curved. That would have been at the top of the incline on the head frame. That's where, and that curve would have stopped the cart from going any further forward on the tracks. And for Stan in Arizona, we noticed here on the tracks a name that says Luxembourg. I'll have to research that and see what that name means and where these ore cart tracks might have come from or where they were manufactured. And that's looking back down into the tunnel we just were in. And we're getting a little bit of rain here, as well as some sunshine.
Looking monsoon.
Okay, so when the talc came out of that mine that's right up there where we just were, this ore chute would have been standing. It's collapsed, obviously, but they would have dumped it into the ore chute after hoisting it up to the top, and it would fall into this covered chute. You're looking at the mouth of the chute there, and this piece right here would have been the chute gate, and that's looking up the chute. And they have ore cart tracks going off here to the right for the waste rock. And then the good ore would go off here to the left onto this trestle. And there's a collapsed ore bin down there that would have taken the good talc, and trucks would have come up that road that we hiked up and parked right there and got the talc out of the ore bin. And you can see the tracks going up there on the trestle. And there's Paul.
I found a rock.
Paul found a rock. And that's it. So outside the mine here is an old miner's bed, just rusting away in the elements. You could probably still get a good night's sleep on that bed, just like the miners did many decades ago.